This is Dr. Joan Talis, the United States planet Earth. Do you read me? Is anyone out there?
Copy.
We're getting feedback. Let's try another channel.
What does that mean? I don't understand what
Kimberly,
that means.
I'm here with Mike Cahill and Brit Marling, makers of Another Earth. So thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having us. Nice to be here.
Nice to meet you guys. So how would you describe your film? And by that I mean, is it science fiction?
I think it is science fiction. I mean, I think Mike and I love science fiction movies, and we're also interested in the kind of sci-fi where if you took the science fiction premise away, there's a substantive drama at its center that would still stand on its own 2 feet or four. That's
or four
crawling.
Feet, yeah. 12 feet if it's a centipede.
That too.
It's a human drama with a sci-fi context. So the background is this discovery of a duplicate Earth where all 6.3 billion of us are also living. And so the possibility of meeting yourself is a real possibility. But that's the context. Inside, we tell the story of a young woman and whose life gets tragically intertwined with this man's. And it's a bit of a thriller that the tension builds up, but it's a romantic, it's hard to describe the movie because it's a romantic drama, it's a thriller, it's entertaining, it has spectacle, and it is sci-fi. So I like that it's hard to put a finger on exactly what it is. It's outside of a box.
And why this subject matter then?
Well, I think we have a deep human yearning to not be alone or to connect. And we have all our friends, our family, our lover, all these people in our lives, but there's this running monologue that we have with ourselves. When you wake up and you look in the mirror and you're like, hey, like, why did you do that yesterday? Or, you know, what are you gonna do today? And we love the idea of taking that person inside and separating them so that you can objectively look at them, because there's certain emotion that satisfies. It satisfies this desire to not be alone, and it also allows you to confront the type of person you are. Would you like you? Would you dislike you? And would you be able to forgive another version of you if they had done something really bad?
In the grand history of the cosmos, more than 13,000 million years old, on Earth is replicated elsewhere.
There's another you out there.
Now you begin to wonder,
the other me made the same mistakes I've made. And is that me better than this me?
Let me tell you a story. It's about a girl. She does something unforgivable.
What about cinema made you both want to be filmmakers?
What about cinema?
Yes.
Such a good question.
Cinema, I could talk about that for a long time. There are certain emotions, I think, that are very difficult to articulate, that we all experience as humans, the ineffable something. And I think film has the power, cinema has the power to convey those. And in a group setting, when you're in a theater, when the lights go down, and you're with all these strangers, and you go on this journey with the protagonist through the ups and downs and a full character arc, and it get to a place at the end, it can really change you. And I think that's profound and amazing.
Something about cinema, it's like you're in this dark space, as Mike was saying, and you're with all these strangers, but you're connecting through this story, and like for a moment you surrender your disbelief and you let go into someone else's imagination, and you're moved. And in that moment that you're laughing or crying, you know, with all these strangers beside you, you somehow feel not so alone. It's a nice feeling.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for joining us, Brit, Mike. Congratulations. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Please don't go. You don't know what's out there.
That's why I would go.
This is a place.